Assalamu alaikum warahmatullah. Malaysia, I cannot wait to come back and do part two of love stories from the Quran. Now, those of you who were there, and I know some might not have been, but those of you who were there, you will know how amazing that night was, where we spoke about some of the prophets of Allah and the stories of love that is interchanged and told to us in the Quran. And we're coming back with part two. We're going to focus on some of the stories of love that maybe we don't know and we need to hear more about. You know, sometimes it's love that is inappropriate, unacceptable, and it's love that we should be fearing of. Like the desirous love of the sons of Adam. وَتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ أَبْنَيْ آدَمَ. Allah gives us the story of the two sons of Adam. And it's the first murder in Islam, and it was because of passion. And it's something to consider and to speak about. We're going to look at the story of the love of Musa's mother for him, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala produced divine intervention, not just to protect Musa. He could have just protected him in the Nile, but he returns him to her so that she suckles him and feeds him and he grows up under her care. Love that she had that attracted back her son after what would have seemed like loss. We're going to look at the love of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as is told through the narrative of the Quran and his seerah. So many other prophets, so many other messengers. Join me inshallah. KL, it's going to be an amazing, amazing journey. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses us with His insight and His love. Love stories from the Quran, part 2. KL, you're the first to receive it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.